deliver me from this body of death. I thank God. I wish somebody would throw your hands up and just say, I thank God. Oh, come on, say it again. I thank God that through Jesus Christ our Lord, so then the mind I serve the law of God, but with the flesh, the law of sin, my soul just couldn't be contented until I found the law. Well, you just touch three people on your row and shout to them and tell them, I'm glad I found the law. I need a few people to help me touch three more people and shout to them and tell them, I'm glad I found the law. There's no shackles on me. I'm as free as I can be because Jesus changed my life. He died. Yeah. Upon the cross. That's why I can tell the world that I am redeemed. I am redeemed. I wish I had a praying church. Bought with the price. Jesus has changed my whole life. And if anybody asks you just who I am, lean on side of somebody and tell them I am redeem. Man is trying to compromise its sinful ways through fellowship and networking, friendship, and through finding fault in scripture, and by conversing in winding circles of confusion, man has almost defined himself as a utopia and is nurturing a spirit that's anti-God. Man cannot save himself. Man cannot redeem himself. Man cannot reconcile himself. Man was in need of a mediator. And that's why it's found in Romans 8:3. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and in for sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. Throw your arms around somebody and say, neighbor, I'm glad that I'm saved today, because the law couldn't do it. My money couldn't do it. My influence couldn't do it. But I need a savior, and his name was Jesus. Clap your hands and shout glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's no Oscar for phonyism. There's no Oscar for manipulation and disingenuous acting. There's no true anointing. That's just foundation in hypocrisy and pride and covetousness. But we came here on this week to tell the Lord to turn the light from heaven on our soul. The holy convocation is the convening of the saints, those who are set apart. It's the coming together of the saints of God. The holy convocation for the church of God in Christ is not a convening of liars. Well, the liars come together and strategize how to become a more effective liar. The holy convocation for the church of God in Christ is not a convening of manipulators and con artists. Well, they all come together to see how can we plot and destroy and be more effective. The holy convocation is not a convening of fornicators and adulterers where we sit up and marry and mess with other married people who are not your spouse and exploit your sexual desires. The holy convocation is not a convening of same-sex individuals that prey on other folk with like minds, but the holy convocation is the church of God that celebrate holiness. The holy convocation is where we come together and fast and pray and celebrate God for our roots in holiness. Celebrate God for our roots in righteousness. Can you say yes? Throw your arms around your neighbor. Shake them by the shoulder. Y'all stop being disobedient. Throw your arms around your neighbor and holler at them. Say, ooh, neighbor, welcome to the holy convocation. Glad you're here. Come on in where the table is spread and the feast of the Lord is going on. The holy convocation is a display of God's power through miracles, signs, and wonders. Can you say yeah? The holy convocation is to celebrate our heritage and our doctrine of holiness. Can you say yeah? It's to celebrate that through it all, preachers have remained steadfast, missionaries have remained on the wall, churches have remained open, backsliders have been reclaimed, sickness has now healed, distraught minds now have peace. Throw your arms around your neighbor and say, welcome to the convocation. Shout yay! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Lastly, we come to the convocation to celebrate what Christ did. Christ did on the cross. I remember the hymnologist say, at the cross, where I first saw the light and the burdens. Y'all ain't praying with me. Ooh, and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there, Lord have mercy. It was there, by faith I received my sight. Now, can I get somebody to help me shout now? I'm happy all the day. Is there anybody here happy? Clap your hands and shout, I'm happy. Lift your hands all over the building. Lift your hands, put your purse down, take off your shoes, lift your hands up, let your mind go back to that Sunday service, that Bible study, that time at home where the Lord changed your life, you can be a witness that it was on a hill far away stood an old rugged cross. It was the emblem of suffering and shame. How I love, is there anybody here that loved the cross? I know you love your church. I know you love your building. But is there anybody here that loves the cross? The blood came streaming down just for me. Can you say yeah? So we came this morning. Can you say yes, Lord? We came this morning before any meeting. We came this morning before any service. We came this morning before any rehearsal. We came this morning to lift up your hands and say, Lord, search me, Lord. Turn the light from heaven on my soul. If you find anything, if you find anything that shouldn't be, take it out and strengthen me. I want to be right. I want to be safe. I got to be whole. One more time, throw your arms around your neighbor, shake them and rock them and shake them, holler in your voice and say, neighbor, I decree miracles, signs, and wonders. Let that arm go, move out of your seat and go help somebody. Signs and wonders. God's gonna do it. He's gonna change your mind. He's gonna turn it around. Clap your hands and shout, yeah!